What about looking at the changing world and seeing what we could do to take advantage of those changes to drive a better and brighter future for Sheffield? That's what we're talking about tonight.
We had an interesting conversation at the table actually about the upsides and downsides of the city as we see it. And actually one thing appeared in both the upside and the downside, and that was actually Student City, because we thought students were a real strength for the city, but actually we were very dependent on them. So you can see those as a strength and a downside.
One of the most significant things we've been discussing this evening regarding change is the impact on connectivity in terms of infrastructure between the cities of the north. And seeing the future change with connectivity between the cities, I think, is essential for us going forward.
So in our group, we were talking about raising aspirations and reducing the inequality gap. There's an existing initiative that I'm aware of, which is the Enterprise Advisor Network, which works in schools where business people go in and act as a role model to have meaningful engagements with children to help raise their aspirations, provide advice about what career opportunities might exist for them, to help with social mobility and help just act as a point of inspiration really for individuals.
So this evening we've been focusing on education, the future of education in Sheffield. Of course, the future as we see it is lots and lots of industry. People won't have jobs for many years. They'll jump from one thing to another, to another, to another, to tasks. People are going to interact in different ways. And with that in mind, we think that the traditional barriers of schools need changing. People will go to a different class, different days, different schools, different days to get the education that they need, to get the right expertise. And we want to pioneer that and try and bring that to Sheffield as best we can to try and make that change happen here, because we think that's positive for the future of everyone.
The world is changing in a way that it's concerned about inequalities, increasingly globalised, increasingly digitised, so people are actually looking for more authentic products and experiences. And we actually think that Sheffield finds itself with some core strengths that can be offered basically as an antidote to some of the concerns of a rapidly changing world. So we are a city of makers and authenticity.
Sheffield's a great city of people who are welcoming and inviting and always willing to put a helping hand forward.
I've really enjoyed this evening finding out about the challenges that Sheffield faces, but also all the opportunities that there are out there in a changing world, about how we've struggled to get our abilities out there in the past, but how we can shout about them in the future.
We sort of wondered whether or not there is the capacity for Sheffield to reinvent the cottage industry for the 21st century. So what would it look like if Sheffield continued to do what it does very well, which is small-scale innovation, small-scale development, but cherished that and supported it and nurtured it in the city centre in a way that it probably doesn't at the moment. And I guess more importantly, celebrated that in a city centre. So thought about why it was the only city really thinking like that at the moment and where that might get it.
One big thing is getting Sheffield to shout louder about the benefits of what it does very well, about innovation districts in terms of that global offering outside the remit of the Sheffield City region, and probably more widely, upskilling the startups that are the medium-sized and bigger business employers of tomorrow. So I think there's quite a few people that got behind that. We're looking at those big changes, the big things which are happening in the world, and trying to envision what that could mean for Sheffield, what Sheffield could do to grab hold of those and drive a bright future for itself.